السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to lesson 22 from Tajweed course, Tajweed Guide to Read Write. Today we will continue the rules of noon. We will start with the rules of idgham today, but from different perspective. Last time we said from the noon rules, the idgham, and the idgham is yarmalun letters. Two of them, you do the idgham without ghunna, la mamra, and then the other four, ya, nun, miman, waw, with ghunna. So the previously we talked about the idgham due to the ghunna and without ghunna. Today we will talk about the idgham due to the complete idgham or incomplete idgham. So the idgham could be complete merging or complete idgham or incomplete idgham. What is the meaning of complete idgham? Complete idgham means to merge the noun completely, its sound and its characteristics, and the characteristic that I mean here, the ghunna characteristics. Each letter has a minimum 5 characteristics. What I wanted here, the ghunna, the famous characteristics for noun. So when you merge the noun completely, that means you have to merge these two. It's a sound, and that means the articulation point of the noun. You don't pronounce the noun anymore. And you merge the ghunna of the noun, or the characteristic of ghunna, so nothing remains. So idgham kamil, we call it kamil in Arabic, complete or complete idgham, means nothing remains from the noun. The noun, when I look to this noon, it's merged to the ra completely. Nothing remains from the noon. When I read this word, I say mir rabbika, mir rabbika. So I don't say min rabbika. If I say min, that means I pronounce the noon from its articulation point. And if I say min, I can't do this ghunna. You can. So you merge it, so no noon anymore. And no ghunna of the noon, nothing remain. Mir rabbika, the same in the next example. Mil ladunhu, it's like you join the meme, kasra direct to the lam, shadda fatha. So if we notice, we will find all with the idgham, the first letter empty without any sign, the second letter has shadda. This shadda means that the first letter merged completely and entered to the second letter and nothing remained. To make you remember, I refer to this easy example, that the noon sound, this is the noon sound, you merge it or you put it into this pot completely. So because you could put it completely, you could cover it with this lid, and this is I refer to this as the shadda in the mushaf, because it's complete idgham, you could put the shadda or the lid, and this put is the following letter, the mim, noon, lam, and ra. So when you merge the noon into lam and ra or mim and noon, nothing remains from the noon, nothing remains from the noon, and you could put shadda on the next letter. But the idgham naqis. Idgham naqis means incomplete merging or incomplete idgham. You merge the noon sound, so no noon, the same like the idgham kamil, but its characteristic or the ghunna remains. And this is in two letters, the ya and waw. The idgham here, it's incomplete and with ghunna. So the example here, when I say min waliyin, I merge the noon. I don't say min wali. No, I change or I merge the noon into waw sakin, like this. And with this waw sakin, I apply ghunna. I say min wali. So no noon anymore, but the ghunna of the noon still there. And you do it with the waw. You change the noon or you merge it into waw, but the ghunna of the noon, you do it when you pronounce it this well. So you pronounce it as this, mu waliyin. The same thing in this example. فمن يعمل. I can say فمن. I have to say it. فمن يعمل as this one. فمن. So no noon anymore. And this noon become like ياء ساكن. But this ياء ساكن have the غنة of the noon. So the غنة that you hear when you read this example, it's the noon غنة. Or the first letter غنة. The تجويد terminology for the first letter, we call it مضغم. The second letter is called مضغم فيه. So when we do the incomplete إضغام, we merge the noon completely, but the غنة of the مضغم or the first letter is still there. So you have to apply it with this ياء and واو. And because it's incomplete إضغام, there is no شدة on واو or ياء. If you search for any idgham in Mus'haf followed by ya or waw, you will find it without shadda. Why? Because it's incomplete idgham, incomplete merging. And I refer to this also in this example. You merge the noon into the ya and waw, this pot, but the gunna of the noon is still there. So you can't put the lid or the cover. So that's why you can't put the shadda in Mus'haf. So in Quran, any incomplete idgham, the second letter without shadda. So both idgham, the first letter always empty. When you find any empty letter from in Mus'haf without any sign, and the following letter has shadda, this is incomplete. This is complete idgham. If it's without shadda, so that means it's incomplete idgham. So what about the meem and noon? So the ya and waw, it's incomplete. When you pronounce it, you merge the noon completely and you do gunna. The lam and ra, you merge it completely but without gunna. When I pronounce the meem and noon, I say mimmal walan nushrika. You hear a gunna. So maybe someone get confused and tell me how you do this غنّة, and you said the إدغام كامل, you merge the noon completely, the sound, it's a sound and it's غنّة or its characteristics. The difference here that the غنّة that you hear is the second letter غنّة. In reading, of course, you don't feel difference. But if I ask you why you did this غنّة, you tell me this is the مضغم فيه غنة or the second letter غنة. And that's why this is إدغام كامل. And you know this from the مصحف. If you open any مصحف and search for نون or تنوين followed by نون or ميم, you will find the نون or ميم has شدة. So if the نون or ميم carry the شدة, that means it's complete إدغام. Whenever you find شدة on the second letter, this is complete إدغام. So the difference between the غنة that you hear in the ميم and نون and the ياء and واو, that the غنة here, this is with ميم and نون, the second letter غنة, but the غنة in the إدغام ناقص is the first letter غنة. In إدغام ناقص, you merge it in ياء and واو. The واو and ياء not from غنة letters. But when you merge the noon completely here into noon and meem, the noon and meem will shadda, it's gunna letters. That's why you hear this gunna. So that's why we said the idgham now from a different perspective. The idgham, before we said it's la man ra and then yanmu. Now we said the idgham is idgham kamil. Idgham kamil bighayr gunna in la man ra. And then إدغام كامل بغنة in ميم and نون. And then إدغام ناقص بغنة in ياء and واو. So the same six letters, يرملون, but you rearrange the letter again and you make it like يو من and لا من راء. To make it with more details that it's a three types now, not only two. إدغام ناقص بغنة, إدغام كامل بغنة, إدغام كامل بغير غنة. We start now the next chart to practice how to apply each rule. So the noon sakina and tanween had these four rules that we did before. The izhar halq letters. I hope that you memorized the group of letters. So the izhar halq hamza ha ayn ha ghain kha. If you find it after the noon or tanween, you apply the izhar halqi, means you pronounce the noon clear. The second is iqlab, if the noon followed by ba, so you have to turn this noon to meem with ghunna. Or the idgham letters, and we know now that the idgham could be incomplete or naqis or complete, kamil. The idgham naqis bi ghunna in ya and waw, or kamil bi ghunna meem and noon, kamil bi ghayr ghunna in lam and ra. Then the rest of the letters you put it in the ikhfa, ikhfa haqiqi, the rest of the 15 letters. But the ikhfa, you have to notice that the ghunna in ikhfa is divided into two types, heavy ghunna and light ghunna. If the following letter after the noon or tanween from heavy group, you will do heavy ghunna. If not, it will be light ghunna. So the heavy letters, if you still remember, it's the group of khussa, dagtin, qiz. But I didn't put the kha and the ghain here. Why? Because they already in the izhar letters. Hamza ha, ayn ha, ghain kha. So the ghain kha here. The rest will be the saad, daad, ta, qaf, va. So the rest will be in the ikhfa group. But if the noon or tanween followed by one of these letters, the saad, daad, ta, qaf, and da, do heavy ghunna. We start together to pronounce the examples. So the first here, it will be clear noon or tanween. The first example. An'amta, wanhar, man amana. فسينغضون سلام عليهم ما أن غدقا. So I hope inshallah I do this word by word to make you practice with each word and try to apply the rules as much as you could. This is the first rules, the izhar halq. The second, the iqlab, I will change the noon into meme sound with ghunna. First one, anbiya fi sumbulihi yumbitu sami'un basir بثمن بخس من بعد. Sometimes I pronounce the last letter ساكن automatically because this is the rules, and sometimes I pronounce the حركة on the top, so it's okay if you pronounce it with سكون or حركة since you do the rules of نون properly because this is short for the نون rules. The idgham, idgham naqis bi ghunna. This is mim tanween followed by ya, so it will be liqawmin yatafakkarun. And this is from a little difficult rules. It needs practice because when you merge the noon into ya or waw, you have to pronounce it 50% from mouth and 50% from nose or the nasal. The nasal sound 50% and the mouth sound is 50%. So if I merge it completely and I didn't do ghunna from the nose, I will say it لِقَوْمِ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. This is only ya. I want ya with ghunna. And sometimes the student do ghunna without mouth part, so he will say لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. I didn't feel from the غُنَّة sound that the next letter is ya. I have to feel this, so you have to share your mouth and do the ya shape or the waw, the ya or waw, and apply غُنَّة with this. So it will be لقوم يتفكرون. لهب وتب. من يعمل من واق. الإدغام كامل بغنة. ماء مهين. ملكا نقاتل. مما لن ندخلها. الإدغام كامل بغير غنة وذ لام راء. ما للبدا. رؤوف الرحيم. من لدنه. من رسول. The إخفاء. We start with the heavy gunna. And إخفاء also from the rules that needs lots of practice because we have 15 letters in إخفاء with 15 different sound of gunna. If you want to make it professionally, each letter has different sound because you prepare your tongue for the following letter. So if the letter from the tip of the tongue, you have to push the gunna towards this part. If the letter from the deepest part of the tongue, the gunna will be deep. If the letter is heavy, the gunna will be heavy. So there's different types of gunna, not one sound. So we start with this. The first example, for example, noon followed by qaf. The qaf very deep. From the deepest part of the tongue, so I have to do it there in the place of qaf with heaviness. So it will be yanqalibun or min siyam. So you see, this is heavy. It's not like, so this is the qaf. If I try to do the kaf, the light one, and from the same place because it's from the deepest part from the tongue too. It will be ankala, anka, not like yanqa. Of course, the gunna here heavier. Yanqalibuna, not like ankala. The next one here. Mintin, mandud. ينظرون. The light gunna. منثورة. You see, very light and from the tip, because the from the tip of the tongue with the tip of the teeth. منثورة. أنكلا. أنجاكم. من سلالة. ذرة في قيلا سلاما. With this example, if you notice also, I put here all the rules that you need to apply gunna. So the all the إخفاء letters, you have to apply the gunna, but sometimes it's a heavy or light gunna. The إدغام, of course, all the or four letters from idgham, you have to do the gunna, the lam and ra without, plus the iqlab. So the and the rules without gunna, all the six letters of idhar and the lam and ra in idgham. With these examples, we reach it to the end of these lessons. I hope you get benefits from this lesson and practice with these examples. Next, inshallah, we will start or we will continue the rest or the last part on this lesson, the exceptions for the idgham and the sakt, inshallah. Till we meet again in the next lesson. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.